Alle Wolken, guten Tag. Hier ist Jovan, my geek scene. Ich bin aus Grand Rapids Comic Con hier mit Frau Lucie Pohl. Lucie, wow. Willkommen Sie aus Michigan. Wie geht es Ihnen?
Sehr gut, vielen Dank. Wow, oh my God, that is super impressive.
Oh, well, I was practicing that, just trying to get, because I know you're German-born, but
yes,
you know,
that's true.
Figure I'd show proper respect to you.
Thank you, that's really sweet. Vielen Dank, Dankeschön.
Okay, I was like, my German is not that great.
Bitte sehr, you're welcome.
Oh, thank you. All right, folks, well, I did my normal intro completely in German for Miss Pohl. But for those of you who don't know, this is Lucie Pohl, the voice actress, comedian. And for the sake of it, since we're at the Grand Rapids Comic Con, she is the voice actress of Mercy from Overwatch.
I'm pretty sure
that's what a lot of people are clicking on, but there's a lot more behind this lady than most people would ever expect if they were just doing surface level stuff. But I don't do surface level. All right. So I mentioned that you were the voice of Mercy from Overwatch. Now, I know that you have your favorite lines and whatnot, but I noticed that you mentioned that the witch skin was your favorite skin. Why is that?
I just think the details are really amazing. I think she looks really badass in it. It's really fun at the same time, and the voice lines that go with the event are really great. You know, they changed Heroes Never Die to My Servants Never Die. And she's got a little bit of an evil touch to her, which is not the usual Mercy we know.
I mean, there was a weird fan theory out there suggesting that Mercy was actually evil.
I know. I had a fan come and tell me about that today.
Who knows?
Comment.
From what I understand, you've done mocap in the past for games. What games did you do mocap for?
Oh God, the last time I did mocap was really, really long ago, so I don't even remember. And it was actually in Germany, to be honest.
Okay.
And then I did a new project that I can't talk about, unfortunately.
All right,
so that's always boring. Sorry.
All right. As I mentioned, you're a comedian. You've created 3 one-woman shows, Hi Hitler, Cry Me a River, and Apohlcalypse. Would you be able to talk about them briefly?
Yeah. So that's Apohlcalypse Now.
Apohlcalypse Now. Sorry.
Yeah. No problem. I'm so impressed at your research. It's amazing.
I try.
So Hi Hitler is an autobiographical solo comedy. Cry Me a River is a one-hour show that's 10 different character monologues. And Apohlcalypse Now is sort of a stand-up storytelling character comedy about 2 years of disasters in my life. And the title is obviously a pun on my last name, Pohl, Apohlcalypse Now.
I mean, I know that you recently, did you do like, not necessarily a remix, but you re-updated Hi Hitler?
I did, yeah, I did. I added about 15 minutes of material to the show. I reworked a lot of the jokes. We reworked the staging. We worked with a whole new team of designers, except the sound designer. He stayed the same. And we kind of revamped it for an off-Broadway run in New York.
Have you finally met David Hasselhoff?
No, I have not. I have not met David Hasselhoff. I kind of think it's good I haven't met him, because then the mystery is still surrounds him.
Like,
you know?
That old saying, don't meet your heroes.
Yeah, I think so.
I'm kind of like that way too. I'm like, oh man, I don't know if I necessarily want to meet you, because like, I have this image in my mind, and then like,
exactly.
If it's tarnished, then that.
And then you don't want
forever.
To see that person on the floor eating a cheeseburger while drunk.
I wasn't necessarily going to bring that up, but I guess that was one of your fondest memories of David Hasselhoff.
Pretty much.
Do you plan on releasing your shows digitally for people who are not fortunate enough to make it out to your comedy?
Yes, I do. Great question. We're working on that. Hopefully we'll have something for you guys soon. In the meantime, I'm doing a show in LA. I just did a show in Oklahoma, so I'm getting to some places outside of New York as well in the States, which is really nice. I might do a show in Miami in January. So,
okay. Now, from what I understand, whilst doing research on you, you've mentioned that Whoopi Goldberg, Lily Tomlin, and Lucille Ball are inspirations to you. Any particular examples of their work that resonate with you?
Well, yes. For Lucille Ball, definitely. I Love Lucy is one of my favorite TV shows of all time. The fact that she started very late and against all odds, and the fact that she brought and the theme of immigration into her comedy as well by including her husband, obviously, Ricky, really resonates with me. So that show is one of my favorite shows. She's just so great. And she was one of the first females to really just like go out there, very courageous, you know, against all odds. Whoopi Goldberg started out with a solo show where she played a lot of different characters, and it ended up going to Broadway, and it was called Whoopi Live on Broadway, and that is probably one of my favorite Whoopi Goldberg creations. And then Lily Tomlin, her character work on SNL, and her collaborations with her partner on stage are what have inspired me really heavily.
Nice.
Yeah.
Now, we talked about your one-woman shows, but you've performed them at the Edinburgh Comedy Festival.
Very good pronunciation.
Edinburgh Fringe Festival. What lessons have you learned from that festival?
Oh, wow. You ask really amazing questions. I feel like, where am I right now? This is incredible.
thank you so much.
Yeah. Well, I learned to perform in front of very different audiences. I learned how to read audiences. I learned how to not really take it personally when you bomb, as you were mentioning before we got started officially on this interview. Bombing means when, you know, the audience doesn't laugh or doesn't respond the way you want to
to your
comedy or heckles you. Yeah. And in Edinburgh, you perform your show for about 30 days straight. Some people take a day off. I never did. I did the first year, but the last 2 years I didn't. And so you perform every day for a month and you get so many different audiences. And so you learn to deal with a lot of different situations and your show becomes really rock solid. So I learned how to deal with different audiences, and I also learned that you know, to make a show really good, you need to put it out there a lot to really work on it in front of an audience. It's really important.
Okay. Now, as a comedian, do you feel that there are some subjects that are off limits in comedy?
I personally do not think that, no.
I feel the same way, but I'm not a comedian, but I have and I enjoy comedy throughout the years, but
yeah.
I personally feel that, you know, given enough time, everything could potentially be funny. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but
I mean, I think
differently.
Yeah, as long as there's no malice, and you know, it's coming from a place of making a joke and being humorous. Peter Ustinov said, "Comedy is just a funnier way of being serious."
Okay.
So I think that's true.
Are there any up-and-coming comedians that you would like to give a shout-out to?
Daniel Simonson, Michael Svetich, Michelle Wolf. She's not really up-and-coming, I guess. She's already there, but she's awesome. I really love Ali Wong. She's also not up-and-coming. But, yeah.
Okay. Briefly tying back into Overwatch territory, I enjoyed your series of videos with, I want to say, is it Carolina? Or
Carolina.
Carolina Ravassa, mm-hmm. Sombra for you folks out there. She has a one-woman comedy show series called Hispanglo-Saxon, and you have your shows. Have you two talked about collaborating on a comedy show together?
We actually have, yeah. We have talked about collaborating. We all want to collaborate with each other. We're all very, like, kind of, you know, in different places and very busy right now, so it's been difficult to kind of get everybody in the same place. But yeah, we've been thinking of doing that and writing something together. It'd be fun.
It'd be interesting to see. And you've mentioned that you would like to do more singing. Is that where the collaboration with El Sagala would come in?
Oh my God. I feel like you've been like,
I promise I'm not hanging
me around for the last 10 years. You know everything about me.
No, I certainly do not.
Yeah, sure. El Sagala, if you hear this, I'm available for a collaboration.
All right. Well, I mean, like, because of you, I checked out his music for the first time. I was like, wow, this is actually pretty cool.
It's really good. Yeah. It's really amazing. I love him. Did you listen to the collaboration he did with Bebo Valdez?
No, I typed in his name and popped up the first YouTube video.
He's a flamenco artist for all you people out there that don't know El Sagala.
Okay. Now, we're going to go a little bit into your acting roles on this part.
Okay.
Let's talk about your role as Vanessa in, I cannot pronounce this, it was translated as Friends Forever. It was a scene with, a show with people doing football or soccer.
Yeah, that was one of my first jobs out of acting school. I moved back to Germany to go to acting school there. And I booked a series regular on a TV show in Germany, and that was Freunde für immer, das Leben ist rund.
Yeah, I would have not got that down.
And I played Vanessa. She was a hairdresser, and she was one of the lead's girlfriends. And so it was like a supporting character in this TV show that was about this group of guys that would play soccer together and kind of experience deeper situations of life.
I mean, the scene that I saw when you were on the rooftop with that gentleman and he passed away, that seemed very sad. Or at least that's what it looked like. It was implied to me, you know, that he had passed away when they finally scored or won the game.
Yeah. So that's my fictional boyfriend's father in the show. And he's sick and he used to be their coach. And so his like last wish is to see them play one last time. And so I wheel him up to the roof of this hospital and they play this game for him. And then at the end, when his son scores, he dies.
Okay. One of the newer shows that you were in, you were in Red Dwarf and you played Harmony, AKA Professor Baldwin. Was she described as a 1920s flapper meets genius scientist during the audition?
Yes, she was. Yeah.
All right. Well, I guess that's that.
That's that. Now, sorry.
I mean, how was your time with that role?
That was one of my favorite projects that I've ever done. That was amazing. Red Dwarf is a huge cult hit in the UK. Everybody knows it and loves it. It's got an amazing fandom, and there's these four lead actors.
I checked it out for the first time while doing research on
it. Yeah, they're just incredible, and they've been doing it for like over 25 years, and it's a complete institution in the UK. And so that was amazing. The writer, Doug Naylor, is just incredible. His writing is so funny, and that's what makes acting fun when you have good writing, you know?
I like the idea of a science speakeasy.
Yeah, that's what the episode is about, more or less.
And I also have to say, I was impressed when you stated that the subatomic events are only perceptible as indeterministic, physically discontinuous transitions between discrete stationary states, a.k.a. the Copenhagen interpretation.
That's right.
I had to type that one out.
Yeah.
All right, and I guess not necessarily a well-known fact, but you created a comic book with your father, Klaus, and Maximilian Bode. Or is it Maximilian?
Bode. Max Bode.
Max Bode.
Yeah.
So is it a trilogy or is it just one comic, the Toppler series?
It's a trilogy. Yeah, okay. It's a trilogy. This happened a while ago. And my father is from this beautiful town in Germany called Rothenburg ob der Tauber. It's a medieval town, and it has this amazing history. So we used the history of the town and fictionalized it with a story of a gypsy girl coming into the town with her father and kind of saving the town from evil and destruction. And we published the book, the comics, in German, English, and Japanese.
Oh, forgive me. I wasn't able to track down a copy to read prior to this.
That's all right. I could have brought you one.
Oh, if I would have known that, I'd be like, hey, could you please bring this for me?
Yeah.
Why was Bode the specific artist chosen?
Max and I went to high school together. We're very good friends in high school and middle school. I always loved his work. My dad always loved his work. And so we kind of created this project because we wanted to work with him.
Okay. Did you have favorite comics yourself?
You know, I wasn't really into comics as a kid, to be honest. Yeah, I was into like Michael Jackson and David Hasselhoff, pretty much.
Fair enough. I was going to ask you about European comics, but I guess not.
No, I wasn't a big comic person.
Okay. There's still some amazing stuff out there. I would definitely suggest, especially based on pure artwork alone, is Black Sad by Juan Canales.
Okay, cool. I'll check it out.
I would highly recommend that. So as we're wrapping this interview up, what's new that you're allowed to talk about?
Oh, God. Well, I'm allowed to talk about my upcoming appearances at Stan Lee's Comic-Con in L.A., and I'm doing a show in L.A. I am working on a film that I can't talk about. I'm writing a film. I can talk about that. I'm writing a film, a dark romantic comedy set on a little island in Scotland. And so we're going to probably be shooting that sometime in the summer in 2018.
Does that have a name? Are you allowed to reveal that?
It's called No Trees on Tyree.
Okay.
And I'm working on a new show, a new live show. Yeah, and that's all the other stuff I'm not allowed to talk about.
Fair enough. I'm not gonna prod.
Boring.
All right, if people wanted to reach out to you online, where could they find you?
On Twitter, that's Lucie Pohl Comedy, LuciePohl Comedy. And then Instagram is You Love Lucy, the letter U, Love Lucy, LUCIE. And Facebook is The Real Lucie Pohl.
Final question for you. What would you like to say to your fans throughout the years, whether through comedy or your recent fans to Overwatch?
I would like to say, heroes never die.
All right, well, thank you. Well, folks, this is Joe from MIGeekScene here with Lucie Pohl at the Grand Rapids Comic Con. Auf Wiedersehen.
Auf Wiedersehen.